Hello everybody and welcome to the next World War II Chronicles of video in my War Thunder Matches series. Today is the, well, it's this. you got the operation for aviation, but for ground forces it is Soviet troops deploy on the border of the USSR, so the title of this video will just be Eastern Europe GF for ground forces. It was again similar to the Kursk one, but nowhere near as horrible. And by similar, I mean everybody is trying to drive the Germans. When I first started the event, it was simple. It was like, I don't know, I can't remember the exact numbers. It was like 7 people were queuing for Russians and 8 were queuing for Germans around my area. And then I came back a little while later and it said something crappy like 9 players are in the Russians and over 50 are queuing for Germans. The reason for that is because the Germans, they get unlimited Panther Ds and Panther As, which are a required vehicle, which was, in my opinion, a stupid balancing idea from Gaige Entertainment. The Russians get the KV-85, T-34-85, and SU-85, and IS-1, all required. But to not limit Panther tanks is a bit, I don't know, a bit shady, but it didn't turn out too bad. But that's not all. The Germans also get, in their limited vehicle spawns, the Tiger H1, the Nashorn, and the Ferdinand. Holy shit. While the only thing the Russians got in their limited spawns, other than the SU-152, was the ISU-122 and IS-2, which alone are pretty good vehicles. As for aircraft, Yak-3, Yak-9T, LA-5FN, the only new things here are the Yak-3, as far as I'm concerned. I took place on the German team, and it didn't actually turn out that bad. There's going to be 2 matches featured here, 2 or 3 matches. I think only 2 matches are going to be featured. It took me 3 total matches to complete. There was actually 4 matches I played, but one of them was a complete failure. It was featured in my recent rant video. And I get about roughly 13 kills. And I have this was my main lineup, my IS-2. Right here, my T-34-85, and of course my KV-85. Yes, I am more of a KV-85 driver than an IS driver, and I'll explain that in a video else time if anybody wants to know exactly why. But either way, my my main majority of driving is going to be in the T-34-85 and a little bit in the KV-85. So enjoy, guys, and I will see you in the next War Thunder video. But before I forget to mention, this was also the 11th Ground Forces task, meaning this was the event that unlocked the Iron Duke 4 Comet 1 for a lot of people, including myself. Here it is on my tech tree, all nice and shiny, as a Tier 3 British exclusive collectible. Anyways, guys, see you later. Okay. Let's do this. For Mother Russia. Yes, I'm driving the Russians, even though the Germans get shit like the Ferdinand, the Tiger H1, Panther D and A, which have no limitations. Yeah, so great. But, I mean, the Russians get the T-34-85, they get the IS-2. I mean, they get some very nice vehicles, so I'll just go with it. Fuck it. I don't plan on doing any fantastic matches here or not. I was gonna go across the bridge. Well. So this here is the T-34-85, just plain old 85. I've also got the IS-2 in my lineup along with the KV-85. Well, Tigerfrost, why don't you have the IS-1 in your lineup? Good question. IS-1 has improved mobility over the KV-85, but in my opinion, the KV-85 has far better armor because it is a square chassis, hull, whatever you want to call it. It's much easier to put yourself in a diamond position and bounce countless shots, while the IS-1 cannot angle its armor. It is always have a flat piece of... Oh, fuck. Okay, it always has a flat piece of non-angled armor that can be penetrated from any direction. It's the same with the IS-2. It's why I don't much like the IS-2. I'm more of an IS-2 Mod 1944 guy, because it's got that increased frontal armor. Now, I don't know what I'm doing here, but... Okay, so we got shite going on around us here. I don't really want to move up too far. He says as he moves up really far. Sure how I feel about this. I do not see where that bomb is out behind me. Oh. Shit, somebody saw me. I can't see them. I shouldn't be surprised, it's typical with an enemy. Didn't even see what it was. Screw the Russian gun depression. It's so shit. It's so shit I could cry to death. Okay, you know what? Fuck this. Fuck everything about it. All of it. Fuck it. I am getting the shit out of here. Piss on it. Fall back! Fall back! Retreat! Our friends, our family, and ourselves will all be executed when we get back, but screw that. Let's just fall back. Nobody's falling back? Okay, fine. I won't fall back. I just don't want to be up there where I was. I've lost my machine gun. Well, in fact, basically everything in my tank is yellow. To explain. Something's fishy. Ha, bitch.
We have taken the initiative.
Okay, that's one enemy, Panzer IV dead. Let's not get ourselves killed here. Oh, god damn it. I gotta remember, Panthers don't have to stop to shoot. Drop artillery over here.
We need artillery support.
Roger that. Artillery, fire.
It bounced. Well, rip me. Oh, I'm surprised it didn't do that thing again. Okay, so KV-85, no, I'm just gonna, fuck it. Oh, shut the fuck up. Well, we managed to get one kill. I'm doing the ground forces one first because, well, you get, it's the next reward. The second of the four rewards. Today you get the Comet 1, the Iron Duke. Or the Comet. I don't know. It's because it's weird. It's like Comet Iron Duke 4. Is it Iron Duke 4 or is it Comet 4? I don't know. So I'm just calling it the Comet Iron Duke then. So, yeah, as I said, the I mean, it's not good armor, but in a diamond position, you can angle your armor, which you can't do if you're in an IS-1. You can't angle diamond position in an IS-1. You can't even face forward in an IS-1. It's everywhere is a weak spot.
A little more effort, and victory will be yours. Attention to the map!
We'll turn to the map. I think we're pushing them back. Oh, maybe not. Oh shit, we just... There's Gunner. He still has a driver. Unless he switches it to his gun position. Nope.
The enemy tank has been destroyed.
Okay, we've got another Panther here. Got his Gunner. That vehicle just disappeared in front of me. Trying to back off. Got his gunner again. He's down on one crew left. Turn to somebody in an IS-2 here. There's not much I can do. He doesn't have like any ammunition in his turret. Okay, now that is a Tiger tank, and the IS-2 missed. Son of a bitch. Okay, we have no protection over here on this side. I must reproduce. Yes, that's what I must do. I must reproduce. Good job, Tigerfrost.
Let's keep the pressure on. Victory is close.
Yeah, and he saw me as well. Lovely. Actually, he's being hit. Bailed out. That's good for me. Now, what about this other Panther? Is he just going to come driving around? I don't know, but let's put it into a diamond position just in case. Two IS-2s on the front over here. We're up on three. That Panther is still very much out there. But where? Unless he's dead. Unless that T-34 killed him. Oh, fuck. No, he's still very much alive. Yes, he is. Okay, he's being shot. Last stand crew. I had to almost snapshot that one. Okay, he's down, pulling back. I mean, yeah, the only good thing about the IS-2, in my opinion, compared to the KV-85, is the mobility. It is far, far better. Well, it looks like we're kicking their ass right now. What the hell's that? I know what that is. That's a Ferdinand. He just hit my gun. Son of a bitch. Commander, I've lost a crew member? Apparently I lost a crew member. He's right there under that fucking thing. I don't have... Oh. Well, yeah. Good job, T-34. You know, I am just going to call it out now. I kid you not. Why can I not spawn in this thing? I guess I just don't have enough points. Okay, interesting. Or wait, maybe. Maybe, yeah, it's probably limited. IS-2, zero, yeah, there's not enough IS-2s left. So I could just sit here and wait. But I'm sure it'll kick me out, so I'm just going to jump into my KV-85. I was going to say, because this always happens to me. When I look on the minimap and I think my teammates have an area covered, so I'm safe from that area, I always get killed from that area I thought I was safe. So, of course, T-34 is over there, of which there were two, I think. Well, there was two earlier, but they must have lost one. Of course, the moment I think it's safe, that's when I get killed from that area. It's the same on urban maps as well. When I think a road behind me is covered by like 10 enemy or by 10 friendly vehicles, I drive forward and get into a position, then suddenly there's 10 enemy vehicles behind me, and all of those 10 friendly vehicles are still there. So, what the fuck? Oh, what can you do? But I'm back, and I saw Ferdinand over there. Thought I was going to get away safe, but nope. Only three spawns this time around again. Let's try and stay in the innards of the city, town thing. And it is a nice map. I like Eastern Europe as well. It's not a bad map. I like urban maps. It's not Kursk. It's not Kursk Arcade. So I'd say they could have Tiger 2s right now, and we would still stand a chance when it's an urban map. In a map like Kursk, you can still flank around and stay hidden, but there's about a 99% chance you're going to be spotted by a Tiger 2 and be mauled by about a million of them. You know, this Ferdinand's going to be an issue. I guess someone decided to kill that Masshorn. Thank you for doing that now. After I die. Good job, dumbasses. Well, dumbass, I guess, because there was only one over there. Okay, we're pushing forward. Watch corners. KV-85 seemed a little afraid to go around the corner there. Oh, I can see why.
The target has been destroyed.
He only had two crew members left. That KV-85 hit his turret. And, well... oh, fuck me. The Yak-9T pulled what I did in the last episode. Tiger! Oh no, shit! They had to pull up! Oh, piss. What do we got here? What do we got? What is it? You know, this thing doesn't reverse for shit.
The enemy is preparing for artillery barrage. Repeat! The enemy is preparing.
Okay, you stay there, mate. You stay there. I'm gonna turn around because what if he tries to flank around us? Oh shit, that was close.
Let's keep the pressure on. Victory is close.
Just saying, what if he tries to flank us? That would be the smart thing to do. Or what if I try to flank him? Please don't be a Panther tank. Oh, he's not here. Alright, bitch. This is what you get for trying to, I got his machine gunner and his ammo. Not good enough, though. T-34 finished him off. I'll be honest, I wasn't expecting him to be looking at me or trying to look at me, but I think he lost his gunner before he could shoot. Five kills? What? When did I get five? I only thought I had four with that Tiger. Okay. Sure. Bad. That's five. That's a third of the way done already. And it's quite fun, I'll be honest. It's quite enjoyable. It's not often that you get to drive your KV-85 against, you know, competent big-ass German tanks. Okay, I take that back. Yes, you do. that Ferdinand was over there and he's now dead. Okay, I'm going to sit here in this position and wait for enemy tanks to come driving out of their spawn. So it's not particularly spawn camping. It just kind of, like, kind of is. Not really, but maybe. I don't know. Well, we cap the zoner boner. There's only one left. Where is he at?
Just keep it up, and victory will be ours.
Maybe he got in a plane. No, we're approaching their spawn point. There's no gunfire. He's in a plane. Either that or unless this guy didn't die. No, he has died twice. Oh, what's that? It's a friendly. Go kick his ass. He's turning, like, very hard. Where the hell is he? This is just the Yak-9 stunt flying. Maybe he isn't a tank. Maybe he was surviving earlier and he's just been driving a route. Or driving about. Because he's not dogfighting anything at the moment, I don't think, is he? See, I'm worried that something's going to pop up behind me. Well, we've got their spawn covered, so I'm just going to turn around here. Fuckers. Alright, 5 kills, not bad.
And it was quite fun. It was a little.
Maybe I should just. Well, see the. Oh shit, I just went lightheaded as fuck. I mean, I didn't get shot at per se. I got hit in my KV-85. I got killed, I guess, yeah. But I think the moral of the story here is. I didn't realize, because I forgot from my experience with the arcade yesterday, I thought that you would have to, because in arcade, you can't just spawn in at the same vehicle again 3 times. You can have 3 spawns, just like realistic, but you can't redrive something you already spawned in with, unless you, I don't know if backups work, but either way, here, you don't need backups. You can just you can spawn in all 3 times with a single vehicle. It just costs Silver Lions to do so. And I think that's a really, really awesome feature. It's really fun to mess around with in that way. So, my KV-85, I didn't really get shot at to the point where I was bouncing shots so that I should just drive the KV-85 instead of the T-34. Since the T-34, I mean, obviously, I'm going to die a lot easier in it. I don't know. I mean, I think I should just drive. I mean, they got the same guns, right? D5T? No, this one has the Zis S53 85mm gun. Well, piss. I don't know. I'll just drive the T-34-85 for starters. Let's go ahead and check the progress. Make sure it is working. Tinks. Yep, 10 out of 30, guys. 2 more matches with at least 5 kills, and I will have my next collectible vehicle that will make its way nicely onto my British tech tree, which I'm going to assume it's going to be a Tier 3 exclusive, since the Comet 1 is Tier 3, but I could be wrong. I don't know. We'll see. That'll be a nice addition, since it'll be the first exclusive ground vehicle for the British, and they don't have much in the way of premiums at all. I'm sure they'll be getting some more soon. We really need a Tier 2 premium. I was thinking maybe a Churchill variant, a Tier 2 Churchill. How does that sound? How would, like, a Churchill Mark 1 or... some type of special Churchill variant. How would that sound as a Tier 2 premium? I think that would be a nice idea. I love my Churchill Mark 3, and I don't think I've really ever driven the Churchill Mark 7 yet, but I'm sure I'll love the shit out of that. I love the Churchills. They're so good. And there's like a million different Churchill variants, and all we have is 1, 2, 3, 4. That's it. That's all we've got for Churchills. We need more. Well, if you don't want to count the Black Prince, all we've got is 3. Okay, let's try this again and see how it goes. I'm quite tempted to just park up behind a building and stay there. comes our first chicken shit, it looks like. There he is. He's got his rockets armed. Fired off his rockets, and thankfully, fortunately, he didn't hit anybody. Anymore? Yeah, there's another one up there, but not knowing if he's a scumbag or not. Park up in the middle now. I've got 6 out of 30 kills. Okay, good, he killed him. Thank you. Don't want him sneaking around behind us. Let's move. Let's go. T-34's charge. Quickly before bombers come in. See, now is about the time I'd say that getting bombed or rocketed, it would still be frustrating, but it would be less bullshit. He killed another one. He bailed out or something. Fired randomly. Okay, if you're gonna watch that area, I'm gonna go over here. We have lost a large chunk of our vehicles up here. Out here, you little shit. See, this is why I like this position. If people don't know I'm here, they just are gonna take charge towards C. Excuse me! Oh! Oh, I didn't. Oh, piss. Hey, fuck off. Holy shit, I killed him? What? How in the fuck did I kill him? What? Oh god, there's a panzer behind me. Not anymore. Okay, good, that's 3 kills so far. Somebody tell me, how did I kill that goddamn panther? He was moving, unless he was on last stand. That would be the only explanation that I was able to kill him. And I feel very exposed. Actually, no, it's a heavy tank. Yeah, but the last time I did that, I got killed. Okay. I don't see any bitches. I need one more kills. That's it. You need one more kills? So you need... one more plural. I don't know. Whatever.
Attention to the designated grid square.
A little more effort and victory will be yours.
We start backing off. We've got tanks back here. Well, the ones that aren't being taken. Okay, I'm going to move up the... canal river thing. Is that a panther? Oh, rip me.
Yes, a hit.
God damn, I bounced 2 shots from a panther tank. I'm not about to bounce 3. I thought that was the dead Panzer IV. Back there, he's got a KV-85 dealer, so I'm going to take this chance to move up quickly.
Attention to the designated grid zone.
There's a lot of them left. You can hear 88s firing off. The IS-1 got the Panther D. Gunner transmission and tracks. Can't see him now. Got him. Nice. Good. I just fired randomly, blindly. Okay, that's a Panther down. Got any enemy? I heard an 88. I don't know if he's been killed. Another live Panther. Yeah, damn right it is. Out of his track. He can't move. Well, he can, but I go for the middle of his tank. Nice. Good. That's another one. That's six. Very nice. Six and six. That gives me 12. 12 kills. Who is that? Is that a Tiger tank? Nah, he's invincible. Shit. Not in a good position here. Either that or I completely missed him. Go for his turret. Jam his turret. Oh, he's already lost a lot of his crew. I think that this is too angled to penetrate. Yeah. Somebody else killed him. Oh, shit. I thought I was getting stuck. So this is... third match that I, well, third successful match where I wasn't killed by chicken shits, and it looks like the Russians have won again. So that's a really nice change of pace. Germans get ridiculous vehicles to drive, but the Russians still come out on top.
Keep it up and victory will be ours.
I think most would say Russian bias. Let me in. Can't this be these buildings have?
Will.
That one guy that said he needed one kills, he got three deaths. Poor guy. Zero kills. Okay, six kills that match. That's good. That puts me up to 12. I just need three more. Three more and I can get today's reward. That'll be 2 of 4 down. Then only 3 more to go after today, and it'll be the KV-2 Mod 1940. Oh, and I got my add-on armor as well. Great. Oh, for fuck's sake. What the hell? How much RP do I need? I need 3 RP. Or no, I don't. I need 13 RP. Meh. I don't know. Still wish that they would... if they're not going to let us like choose where we want to put it... then they should give us some different presets. Like maybe presets that focus more on hull, one that's balanced, kind of like this, or one that focuses more on turret. Because then that would give it a little bit more... what's the word? It would give it a little bit more variety. Otherwise, everybody's going to unlock add-on armor, and everybody's going to have the same exact tank. So it's not that unique. I don't know. Maybe they'll do that in the future. They have said that they're going to work on more customization options in the future, so maybe we'll see that. Okay, let's just make sure that everything is going all right here. That's aircraft, you dumbass. I like how I say that's aircraft, you dumbass, yet I still scroll all the way down. What is tomorrow? Oh, no. I think it's going to be Brits, Australian versus the Japanese. That's going to be interesting. But today is the 11th task. I only need 2 more kills. I thought I needed 3. If I got 12 total kills now... maybe I missed one in there. Whatever. 2 kills? Not bad. That shouldn't be too bad.